Hello everyone and welcome back to the workshop. Today we're going to be building up Moebius Ford 1968 F250 custom cab. We get to build more of a work truck, a plain Jane work truck, not all decked out with fancy stuff. We're going to check out what's in the box, hopefully these cool hubcaps and the steelies. We'll have to take a look. As always, Moebius has some really nice box art, shows you the finished model, the options of the 360 or 390 V8, and the regular F250 chassis. So let's see what we got going on. As always, when you get this these Moebius Ford kits, you will get a massive box full of parts, and you will have tons and tons of spare parts, intakes and air cleaners and pedal mounts and all this kind of stuff. You'll get a gajillion drive shafts in your kit because they produce multiple levels of this kit. You get two entire transmissions with all these Ford kits. You get all kinds of stuff. I've built these numerous times. They go together quite well. Here we've got a nice looking tailgate molded in this tan color. Suspension, rear bumper, nice utility bumper there, always like that. Steel wheels, front and rear, radiator, steering wheel. You can see as they reuse these molds over and over and over again, we're starting to get a little bit of flash as the molds wear out. It's absolutely easy to cut off those, so stop whining about it. We got our block halves and engine. This is to mount the engine in the frame. Got our nice manifolds. The engines on these build up so sweet. We got our single piece work truck exhaust, carburation, alternator, even little breathers and stuff. If it's an option on that vehicle, the manual will tell you which ones to use. We got that F250 chassis. Looks nice and straight to me. Long box truck, obviously. Nice looking frame there. On this one, we've got another intake, depending on the engine you want to build up, engine fan, fuel pump, air cleaner, another steering wheel, coil, oil filter, cylinder heads. So you'll be jumping around between parts trees because it's got a ton on there. We'll get all these out here right now. These are the parts for the box. We'll get another one out. We got another one hiding down there. We got our inner fenders for the box. Usually these square themselves up as they build. Use a good glue. I like Plastruct Bondine, which is available from Model Roundup. Got the bed right there with its cross members. Got our bed sides. Last time you'll see them looking like that, usually these things started to rust pretty quick. The molding on here is really nice. Looks like it has the chrome trim. We can get all that detailed all the way around there. That bed again. We've got our cab floor. We've got the back of the cab. We've got that nice Ford hood with the Ford emblem raised on the front. Bottom of the hood looks scale, so does the interior tub. Got our rough texture for carpeting and our bare steel. What else we got going on? We've got our brake backing. You can see it's actually got the detail in there. Spare. It's got all the lug holes molded out. Spare tire carrier. Another set of steelies, maybe 250. Explicit, that's why they're in there. Got our interior bench seat, plain Jane door panels, really nice looking, great detail on those. We've got another set of steelies. These must be the F250 ones with the multiple bolts, the hubs, so much stuff. You can have parts galore. Two different types of differentials on there. Looks like one's a front, one's a rear for the four-wheel drive trucks. We got our leaf springs, check them out. Thicker for the F250. Air cleaner, driveline, steering, suspension, engine mount. That's that large pin that goes in the oil pan. You can never get the engine in the wrong place in a Moebius kit. Steering box, brake master cylinder, pedals, even with a clutch, brake, everything. Parking brake, all of that on there. Wheel backs, battery, shock absorbers. Look at the little sway bar mounts in there. So tiny. Tank, jack, horns. Moebius kits really give you a lot to work with. We've got our 1968 dashboard. Beautifully detailed. Steering column. Don't snap those off. Underhood braces and firewall and the inside of the tailgate. Finally, we get to the cab, and that brings us to the end of the plain styrene. Great detail. Going to be able to make that look pretty nice on the model. We'll switch sides of the desk. We've got the clear parts, windshield. The windshield's always going extremely tight on these trucks. Back glass, side glass, headlights, and transparent red taillights. Like it when they do that. We've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 chrome trees in this kit. I don't know how they pack that all into a standard size model box. We got our Ford emblems with extras. We got what definitely looks like cab lights, cab markers there. Got our beautiful grill. Check that out, molded open. Nice detail on that. Some hubcaps, door handles, rear view mirror, more emblems, gas cap hiding on that one. More hubcaps. This one's definitely open for the front end. Superb detail on those. A flat coat makes them look like stamped steel. We've got chrome bumpers. Love the work mirrors on there. Two different styles of mirrors. Three different styles of mirrors. Valve covers. More emblems. Windshield wipers. Under hood for the other different, for the different Fords that have that chrome trim on the hood. We've got a set of 5 tires. These are not like the tires in the other Moebius kits. They are much more heavy duty, more of an aggressive tread to them. Black wall on both sides. You will get 5 of those. We've got a set of decals here. And once again, in my just my opinion, Moebius drops the ball, fumbles it, lets the other team pick it up and run it into the end zone. Why the people at Moebius hate this front Ford logo? I think they've only included the letters in one of the kits. We've got the tailgate letters, that's awesome, in white and black. We've got some nice Red Rock Farmers Market logos. Dash decals, awesome. Side logos, custom logos, engine decals. Auto light decal for the battery. Why must you always forget these Ford letters in the front so that we have to draw them on by hand? I do not know. It's really my only gripe about the Moebius kits. They are lovely kits. The instruction manuals are in full color. They're exploded and written. And then in the back, you will get a full color paint guide with paint splotches to let you know what colors if you want to paint it. Interior look, see, dashboard, and body. Why they don't have those Ford emblems when they do everything else, I don't know, but they don't. Maybe if I keep complaining about it, they'll get them. But I'm going to start assembling mine, and I'll see you over there. Thank you. After a couple of hours, the Moebius pickups go together quite well. It's not really difficult to assemble these. The molds are getting a little older, so there's a little more flash to clean up. Some of the holes might have to be opened up with the tip of a hobby knife, but it's nothing bad, but they're reproducing these molds over and over and over again. Now you see everything here is a much less amount than all those parts that we have. I have a whole set of sprues inside the box ready to get recycled because it's all stuff we're not going to be using. But we got the spare tire here now that we've narrowed everything down. All those holes are open in it. I like that they did that on that one. Looks much more accurate under the truck or in the bed too, because these are such nice tires. We might take it off the spare and just toss it in the bed for that, you know, nice little look in the vehicle. We've got our front and rear wheels on different trees. So I removed them to make sure I didn't paint and use the wrong ones. Got our radiator cut free. That's ready to go. Our drive shaft's on there, but I'm not going to cut everything free. I'll just paint the whole thing and install it. I got the proper air cleaner for this model. We got the right brakes, the power booster for the model, heater lines. We can paint those up. Exhaust. I like to cut all the trees separately so I can hang on to them. I have the period correct steering wheel per the manual. I just followed the manual's directions, so if they've made a boo-boo, oh well, I'm never going to notice the difference. We've got the dashboard. We'll get that painted in the same color as the body. We've got our pedals in this one, supposed to be an automatic transmission. So we've got our gas brake and parking brake. If you had a manual transmission, you'd be using that one. And they have all the pedals for that. Got our belt and pulley system together. I glued it now. You could always paint the alternator and attach it later, but I'll just hand paint it. We know I like my silver colored paints. On this tree here, pretty much the only thing I need off of it, but since it's all on here, are the horns, the jack, the reservoir, and the battery. The visors can go in if you choose to put them up in there, if you're going to be looking up into the interior. And then we've got our interior. Our large bench seat and our door panels. We'll get our door panels sprayed, and then we'll have to mask and do stuff like that to get them the body color on the outside. As you can see, I've just got it kind of pressed together here on the bench so we can see it. Now on this one, the tailgate will open like they will on all of them. Usually I glue it on. I decided to try it and just attach it later. So there's our tailgate inside and out. Like that it's got the impressions there and everything. We'll get that painted up and mounted on the truck. The hood fits in. Now, normally I'd glue the chrome trim on later, but I always seem to have an issue with the paint when I do that. So I will mount it now with some super glue like we saw. I will spray it, and then all I need is that little line to be chrome, so I can do that with my chrome marker or a silver Sharpie, whatever I want to do. And then I don't have to worry about screwing up the paint with the super glue at a later point. Always seems to be where I have trouble is a little bit of super glue at the end and then it ruins the paint. So we've got our big honking Tree 90. She's got a Tree 90 in her with an automatic. Beautiful engine, PCV valves, breathers, ignition coil, distributor, carburation, everything on there. Oil filter, fuel pumps, manifolds. I like to paint my engines all in one and then mount them in and paint the small details. It's always what I've done since I was a kid and I really enjoy it. I'm going to continue doing that way. Moebius, I think, has some of the best engines in the business in their vehicles. They really get into that because car guys like to build those engines and detail them. It's one of the most important features on a model vehicle. Got the cab here. We'll lift off the frame. Got our cab interior I just pressed in so it would sit on the frame. On here we install our fuel tank or the back of the cab. And then the door panels will just press into these large grooves later. So we can detail those unless you want to paint them on and spray it all one color. That's up to you. Whatever you want to do that makes you happy. On the cab itself, I put the firewall in. And the hood support, the hood latch, you could always do those separately later on your own, but I always put them in for strength. They slide in beautifully from the top and then hold in place. Just hold them a little bit with your Plastruct bonding, which is the glue that I like to use at modelroundup.com stocks. And if you hold it for a little bit, that glue dries so fast and it just holds instantly. The box goes together out of multiple pieces and squares itself up. Look at that, no gaps, no runs, no errors. No problems, no filler needed. It looks wonderful. And every bit, the scale part, it's got that nice trim on there and everything. Nice looking, nice looking box on there. That will mount to the frame with these four large pins underneath. And the frame has the four pins. When it goes in, I just like to put a little super glue in each hole, hold the model up, line those pins, and snap-a-doo. You can see I'll slide my fingers around, it won't move. And it just goes in, and it just works. I love it. On this chassis, one of the few times I've assembled a Moebius chassis and I didn't get that inherent twist in it, this one's actually straight, so great job. Not a problem with that one. Got our wheel backing plates, got our suspension in. All in place, got our motor mounts. Man, you got two different size motor mounts, so remember that to follow the directions. Got our steering and our linkage. And we've got those heavy duty springs in the back. With the wheelbacks, we got our spare tire mount. Why do we do that now? Because I can just slide that spare tire in it and then put the box on it. I don't have to get to it from underneath, same as the exhaust and the engine. I'll mount all that stuff on the frame, and then we'll be done. Got our shock absorbers in place. Got our big 250 rear end. And we're all set to go. So now, all I got to do is get over to the paint booth and start throwing color.
Thank you.
It's time to take a look at where we are. Before I finish up the build, we've got some minor parts to attach. I've got like the wee door handles, things like that to put on. Nothing major. Bumpers, you can decide what mirrors you want. You can go with the box start, you can go with the instruction manual, or you can put on whatever mirrors you want. It's an F250, it's a work truck. Swapping mirrors is a very common thing. We've got the heater hoses to go on and the radiator line on top to go on last. We've got our engine in place, got our interior just sitting on there, got our box sitting on there. The cab is all set. Got our logos on the side of the cab. Got our chrome trim painted on the front of the hood. We've got all the parts to our underhood installed. We got the battery, the master cylinder, the reservoir, and the jack in there. And we've got that nice looking grill. I went and Del coated all those parts. I don't want this truck to look like it's rusted at all on the body wise, but it is, let's say, a couple years old and it's a work truck. I do like the Red Rock Farmers Market decals. Probably going to use those. So I wanted to put some stuff on there as if it's actually being used, but not anywhere near older or beat up. You know, this would be like, let's say 1973. It's like 5 years old. It hasn't started to rot out or anything yet. So we've got our windshield and our glass in. Of course, the windshield is an extremely tight fit as usual, but the side glass and the back glass fit in beautifully. No issues with that. And we got all of our chrome trim and our drip rail and everything all situated. Looks nice. Got our turn signals, got our headlights installed, paint behind the grill black so you don't see a big red firewall back there or a big red radiator support back there. We got the box done. I wanted to scratch that up with some silver. So that's all set. Got our tail lights in, got our door, our tailgate latch on there, and our trim done. So that's ready to go. The interior is all put together. All nice. You saw me mask that off. We got a tan interior, red dashboard, black floor. Pretty much copied the manual on that one. Steering wheel. And then instead of using the decal, this time I wanted to see what it would like if I just used a paint marker to see how well the engraving is. And it's absolutely gorgeous. Looks, the decals weren't needed at all. But if you want to use them, they work just fine. And of course, I made sure to paint the bottom of the cab red so that it matched when I put it underneath. If I left it plain plastic or black, it would stand out quite a bit. The chassis is all set. We'll move our air cleaner to the side. We've got our big motor in there. I rusted the manifolds a little bit the same way that I rusted the exhaust and the frame. Exact same techniques. Bolted the spare in there, did the spare in a blank steel wheel, and then attached it on there. Ran our exhaust, got our drive shafts installed, proper one for the F250, engine and transmission, and that gorgeous wheel and a little bit of a larger tire package on there with the hubcaps. If you use the hubcaps, it doesn't matter where you put the wheels. It doesn't, can't see the hubs anyways, and they look awesome on there. So we got just some surface rust on the frame, which would be totally normal from chips and you know, being on the bottom of the vehicle, sandblasted and stuff like that from the road with some wear and tear. After 4 or 5 years, the first thing to start to rust is the chassis. With the bed, we've got that fresh metal because they're always sliding stuff in and out. Got the bed rails, the back, and the tailgate scratched up on its edges. So all I have to do is pretty much shove everything down together, glue the box on, glue the bumpers on, and the mirrors that I choose to use, put my decals on, hand decorate the Ford logo on the hood because I don't include decals for it, give it a coat of clear, just one, just so it's basic cleared, and we will have our final. And here we go with the final of Moebius's Ford 1968 F250 custom cab, their latest iteration of the Fords, the F-Series. You saw the previous one, a cooperation with Model King, sent over by the peeps at Model Roundup. And now you see this version. I do like this version. It does remind me of someone whose dad owns a really cool red two-wheel drive F-250. Theirs is a more modern diesel, but it's like from the early 80s, so late 70s. It's pretty close. We got the 68. There's not a huge amount of differences in those trucks as they went on. So it's a really nice model. Goes together very easily. The decals lay down beautifully. The trim is more than prominent enough to do your work on it. The grill is just a friction fit. The windshield is really the only whine or complaint about fit on the kit. the wheel and hubcap and tire package on this F250, is lovely. Absolutely lovely and fits the bill. And it's the correct multi-bolt pattern on those wheels if you decide not to use the hubcaps. If you use the hubcaps like I have, doesn't matter which wheel you put on the front or the back. I scratched up the bed. I used the four decals on the tailgate. The taillights go in easy. I used the logos on the door and on the bed and had to hand draw using a metallic marker on the hood because, again, Moebius, for some reason, continues to not like putting the Ford logos for the hood in the box. We also did a little mini test of a new paint I picked up called Color Shot. I don't know who makes it. It's not them because it says manufactured for Color Shot. It works quite well. It sprays heavier than Rust-Oleum, meaning more paint comes out when you spray it, but it lays on thinner. It's a more watery paint. It didn't run, it didn't drip, it didn't give me any issues. It laid smooth. Here's one thing though about this paint, which I got at Walmart for $4.97 a can. It stinks. And I mean stinky stink. I always wear a proper ventilator when I'm spraying. And then I leave the basement for the rest of the day. When I do my spray painting, I'm done for the day. I go up, take my mask off, and I go upstairs. I didn't have that mask off for even 30 seconds, just shutting the lights off downstairs, and it was driving me nuts. Stinky, stinky, stinky. So before you use any of that on your next model, which works out quite well, as you can see on a model, worked just fine over primer. Haven't shot it on plastic yet, but the back says you can squirt it on plastic, so we'll see. Stinks to high heaven. Luckily, I got a big house. I didn't have to smell it for too long, but yeah. So just beware of that. If you live in an apartment or other places where someone might be sensitive to it, that stuff stinks bad. Maybe paint outside or with a better ventilation fan to blow it all outside. So anyways, back to model roundup, sending the beautiful F250. Excellent kit. I highly recommend it. Check out that detailed underbody. Looks awesome on the kit. Even got the full-size spare. I did it with a steel wheel. Just put some minor rust and wear and tear on the body and let it go. The cab isn't glued on all the way. In fact, it's just friction fit. So when you see it not line up on the side, it's because I picked it up and moved it and all this kind of stuff. If I were to glue the cab down to the frame, it wouldn't move again, but it lines up nicely and you just have to push the other side down and glue it tightly. As always, we want to thank Model Roundup for sending over this kit. It is in stock right now with them, and I will link it for you in the description. As always, make sure you enjoy building your models. Have fun, smile, realize it's just a hobby, and we'll see all of you at the next review.